who have joined to celebrate with us this morning the Eucharist and also to tell us about the needs of his diocese in St. Thomas. We will have a second collection today, and that will be to support the important work in his diocese. Welcome, Bishop.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord,
Therefore, we rebuke offenders little by little, warn them and remind them of the sins they are committing, that they may abandon the wickedness and the living, O Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
with regard to the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and our assembling with him, not to be shaken out of the mind suddenly, or to be alarmed, either by a spirit or by an oral statement, or by a letter alleging from us to the effect that the day of the Lord is at hand. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. Because many people went to bed yesterday and some of them woke up sick and cannot move, or others did not even wake up at all. We are here because God's blessing. God is good. All the time. Count your blessing and then one by one.
Count your blessing, see what God has done. Count your blessing and then one by one. And you will see the blessings of the Lord has done.
Brothers and sisters, I come to you from the Virgin Islands. I was born in Cameroon, Africa. Studied there, completed my studies and major seminary in Yaoundé, then came to the United States way back in June 1980. And I came to Washington, D.C. I continued my studies in Washington, D.C. with the oblates of my Immaculate OMI. And at some point, I took some time off to discern more about that vocation. Then Cardinal Marley, who worked with me in Washington, D.C. as a priest of the Archdiocese of Washington, was named bishop in the Virgin Islands. At that point, I was studying in Illinois, then completing my graduate course over there. And he invited me to come to the Virgin Islands and serve as a campus minister. So I went to the Virgin Islands. I loved the Virgin Islands. I saw that I would not have to dig the snow anymore. I decided to stay over there and be ordained for the Diocese of St. Thomas, the U.S. Virgin Islands. So I've been there as a missionary for 32 years. His Holiness Pope Francis decided that he would make me a bishop, so I am the chief shepherd of the Diocese of St. Thomas in the Virgin Islands. So I thought that it was about time for me to start thinking about my retirement, but the Pope didn't think so. So I am there now. Basically, I'm here because I have been invited by your bishop. My predecessor also used to come to this diocese because, being a missionary diocese, the Virgin Islands had to rely a lot on many parishes here in the United States to minister, in order to minister to the people in the Virgin Islands. So, brother and sister, I come to you today with a message. But I was given some warning. I was told to keep it short. So if you see that I'm too long, please just wave your hand and I will stop. Also, I'm here to express our gratitude to you. What? For what you have done over the years, not just for the Virgin Islands, but many other mission countries or mission parishes. We have benefited a lot from you and my people of the Virgin Islands would like for me to express their gratitude to you, to many benefactors who have helped us along the way. Since my message today is going to be delivered in the context of the Sunday liturgy, please allow me to say something about the readings of this weekend. Brothers and sisters, this weekend, the readings invite us to think about conversion and repentance. In the first reading, God wants us to repent. This is what we learn. In the second reading, Paul speaks of the deed of the Lord. In the Gospel, Zacchaeus dines with Jesus and repents in the process. The mercy of God is an all-embracing mercy, and it breaks down the barriers that man erects. St. Augustine will say, trust the past to the mercy of God. The present creature to his providence. Today's gospel presents us with an event that happened in Jericho, when Jesus entered the city and was welcomed by the crowd, a big crowd. In Jericho lived a man by the name of Zacchaeus, the chief of the publicans, that is, of the tax collectors. Zacchaeus was a wealthy agent and an agent of the Roman occupation, an exploiter of his people. Out of curiosity, he too wanted to see Jesus. But how to do that with such a big crowd and being of a small stature? He then used his brains, he used his mind. He devised a means, and the means was to climb on a sycamore tree. But this man, a very important man in that community, because he was a tax collector, people that represent the authority, so to speak, but he would go on to humiliate himself and to climb on a tree like a child. And he did that. He couldn't care less about what people would say about him. Certainly some people were laughing at him, but he went on and climbed the tree to see Jesus. Jesus realized that this man wanted to see him. He then called him and said, "Tonight I will dine at your house." Jesus invited himself to the home of Zacchaeus. Brothers and sisters, when Jesus meets us, great things happen. When Jesus meets us, great things happen. And when we enter or we open our hearts to receive the Lord, we no longer descend. And this is why I'm very happy this morning, because you came here to encounter the Lord. You will not go back the way you came, brothers and sisters. And many people will be blessed because you have encountered the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
So if you did not bless, it's because you are starving the presence of the Lord, the presence of the Holy Spirit within you. Do not starve the Holy Spirit within you. Unleash the power of the Holy Spirit, and you will touch many lives, and people will see the transformation of our Lord Jesus Christ in you. And this is why this message today makes me so happy, because I know that many people out there, when you live here, after listening to the word of God, you want to try to do what Zacchaeus did. He then decided to give to the poor. He decided to reach out to the needy, only because he encountered our Lord Jesus Christ. Not only you will encounter the Lord, but you will receive him in the Holy Eucharist. So, brothers and sisters, this is the message for today, and I'm glad to share it with you. Now, let us talk about my diocese and what I came here to do. The Diocese of St. Thomas in the United Virgin Islands is comprised of four islands. First, it is situated in the Caribbean, at about 50 miles away to the east of Puerto Rico. It is an area that is well known for its natural beauty and beautiful beaches. Our economy is essentially based on tourism. Over the years, brothers and sisters, the United States Virgin Islands have been hit by many devastating hurricanes. Every year, we are on the path of the hurricane. But the most recent ones, Irma and Maria, have almost decimated our islands, and up to now, we have not yet recovered. So many of our structures have not yet been rebuilt. As if it were not enough, COVID-19 pandemic has inflicted a crucial blow to our region, cutting off for all of us for almost 2 years from our main activities. No worship, no tourism, and no tourism, no resources. To continue our work of evangelization and run our church program, we have to seek help from our sister churches outside of the Virgin Islands. This explains why I'm here. Without your generous participation in our recovery effort, it will be very difficult for us to significantly minister to the people of our diocese and touch the lives of the poor entrusted to our care. In addition to helping us restore our churches, convents, and rectories, Mission Cooperative Grant Collection will help us fund our soup kitchen, our shelters for homeless, and various outreach programs. Thanks to your partnership, we will make a difference in the lives of the souls we are called to serve. To truly picture what our challenges are, it might be a wise idea to visit our islands when we get a chance to do so. Perhaps some of your parishes will entertain the idea of adopting some of our struggling Catholic schools. The urgent need to complete is to complete the construction of a convent in one of our schools. We were blessed to have nuns, and for now we are renting far away from the school where they are called to work. But we decided, since we do not have any students to cover the whole campus, we decided to take one of the classrooms and transform that into the convent. So we will need the resources to complete that project. Brothers and sisters, we have seminarians, and we are blessed to have them, but we do not have a seminary of our own. So we have to send them to the mainland or even to Rome for their formation. But it takes anyway between $25,000 to $35,000 a year for the formation of a seminarian. And we do not have that money sitting someplace and waiting for us. Our parishes, as well as the churches, currently rely on subsidies to cover the cost of our operations, especially since the devastating hurricanes have inflicted a serious blow to our economy and destroyed our tourism industry. We are struggling to make ends meet, more so now than before. But we remain faithful and hopeful. We are committed to maintaining and preserving a strong Catholic presence in our rapidly changing region. We have a good number of immigrants. Many of them come to us as a Catholic, and we see some of them changing their faith because non-Catholics are ready to welcome them and integrate them into their own church affiliation. And so we have been in prepared to integrate them, but we do not want them to continue that way. We want to be able to reach out to them as soon as they come to Catholic Charity Virgin Islands and make sure that they know that the Catholics are in the Virgin Islands. So we will need your help to do that. So your prayers and support will empower us to get the job done. So, brothers and sisters, with renewed gratitude for what you have done, for what you can do for the people of the Diocese of St. Thomas, I reassure you of our prayers for each one of you. May God bless you, so that you in turn will help us bless the poor, the lame, the crippled, the hungry, and the needy in the Virgin Islands. I hope I did not go beyond my time. And thank you for being so patient with me. May God bless you again, so that you too will bless the people of the Virgin Islands. Thank you for having me.
Today, so the second time the basket comes to you, it will be for the sport of the dice. St. Thomas. If you are unprepared to give a gift today, but you would like to, Bishop Jerome's going to be around all week, so I invite him next weekend.
Thank you.
acceptable to God Almighty Father.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the
and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for a friendly care. us, we pray, so that renewed by these heavenly sacraments, we may be prepared by your gift for receiving what they promised through Christ our Lord.
Amen. A couple of announcements before we go. It's a busy week ahead. So a mixture of Phillies and Eagles and Union schedules. Tomorrow is Halloween. Get all those other personalities out of you. And then come join us as we shine our halos on All Saints Day. All Saints Day is Tuesday. There is no vigil mass. The masses are on All Saints Day, November the 1st at 8:30 and 6:30. 8:30 in the morning and 6:30 in the evening. The next day is All Souls Day, not only day of obligation, but come and celebrate with us again the same schedule, 8:30 in the morning, 6:30 in the evening. The 6:30 evening mass, we will remember in a special way all those whose masses of Christian burial we have celebrated here in this church. Next weekend at this mass, the 10:30 mass, our own bishop, Bishop Koenig, will be with us as we join and welcome the Office for Black Catholics and celebrate the feast of St. Martin the Poor. So that's next Sunday at this 10:30 mass with Bishop Koenig. Again, I want to thank Bishop Jerome for being with us and telling us a little bit more about his work in his diocese at St. Thomas. I don't know about you, but the only times I've been to St. Thomas or St. John was on a cruise. A very limited vision of what those wonderful islands are all about. And now we all have a friend in the Virgin Islands we can go visit, and he can show us the greater beauty of those islands. So, as I told the bishop, many people have been asking me if I do pilgrimage trips, maybe we should put St. Thomas and the Virgin Islands on our tour. So thank you. Thank you, Bishop, for being with us. This afternoon, so they'll be here for a while today. We have Mass once a month in Swahili. There is a reception right after this, because now we've gone into lunch almost. So, great, crossed in our hall. There are some pastries and some coffee and drinks and some tea sandwiches, and your job is to make sure that none of it ends up in my refrigerator.
CW.
No, no, the whole thing.
Oh, the whole thing? Okay.
Yes.
The whole thing. Okay.
Give me that. Is this stopped, Dave?
Wait. I'll be back.
I don't think it's stopped.